Good morning, everyone. Darius Dale here to present our macro minute for Tuesday, November 23rd, 2021. Starting with markets, we got stocks flat to down this morning with Europe underperforming. Commodities mixed, crypto mixed, got the dollar up small, global bond yields up a decent amount. Big movers, WTI and silver down 1% apiece. Ethereum up 1%, nat gas up 5%. Two-year yield up 5 basis points to a fresh cycle high of 0.64%. On the economic front, starting with policy, we have Biden out with an SPR release that's obviously weighing on energy markets to some degree. Global flash PMI data were largely confirming of our post-Delta bounce view extending itself into November. So with respect to the data that were improving, we had Australia manufacturing, Australia services, France manufacturing, France services, Germany services, Eurozone manufacturing, Eurozone services, and UK manufacturing. Nothing unchanged, and then declining only a couple. Germany manufacturing PMI and the UK services PMI. Again, these are November flash PMI data for coming out from the global economy. US flash PMI data will be out at 9:45 a.m. Eastern this morning, expected to improve on both fronts. We're still watching in terms of the most important data point I think we're going to get today. We're going to get South Korea's December manufacturing business survey out overnight. We'll look for that to clues on global supply chain dynamics heading obviously into what has obviously been a pulled forward holiday season. Either way, taking it to the chart here, either way, rates markets are calling for an accelerated pace of tapering and an accelerated or sooner start to tightening. As you can see, we're now hitting new cycle highs for the 2022 euro dollar calendar spread. We're actually seeing a little bit of uptick in recent weeks with the 2023 calendar spread. And that, in our opinion, is why we've seen a little hawkish tilt to bond yields off the lower boundary of the probable range that we tapped a couple weeks ago. We don't necessarily believe that we're going to see a runaway in the 2023 spread as a function of the growth outlook. But again, a lot of the supply chain dynamics and the intensity around that debate is really being concentrated in 2022, which we think is very appropriate. Getting to today's probable range setups, overbought signal in the VIX, currency volatility, US dollar versus Canadian loonie, 10-year tip shield, oversold signals in the DAX, the Russell 2000, WTI, and gold, also Bitcoin and Ethereum as well. S&P 500 probable range setup, minus 0.8% downside versus 2.5% upside. WTI, 0% downside versus 17% upside. Bloomberg Dollar Index, minus 1.7% downside versus 0.1% upside. You'll notice that a lot of currency and commodity exposures are at the lower boundaries of the probable range as a function of the dollar being at the upper boundary of its probable range. 10-year treasury yield, minus 16 basis points of downside versus 14 basis points of upside. Bitcoin at the lower boundary of its probable range with 26% of upside. Same thing with Ethereum, 26% upside there as well. And then gold, 0% downside versus 6.4% upside. So a good spot to start to accumulate, incrementally accumulate some of these exposures, particularly on gold and crypto. With that, Darius Dale presenting our macro minute for Tuesday, November 23rd, 2021. Best of luck out there.